Students, how are you all? So I hope you have understood chapter 2, that is microorganisms, friend and foe. So today we will revise this chapter fast. I will not be able to explain you each and everything in detail, because that I have already explained you, but I will just revise the chapter in short. Okay, so open page number 23. You all know what are microorganisms. Microorganisms are living organisms, but they are very very small, so they cannot be viewed with the naked eye, and they can only be viewed by the microscope. So that is why they are called as microorganisms. Organisms means living things, micro means very very small. These microorganisms are also called as microbes. Okay, and these microorganisms, they are very very small. They are one cell, some of them are maybe many cell. Okay, but since they are living, they show all the characteristic properties of living things. What are the characteristic properties of living things? They need food, they respire, they excrete, they have a lifespan, they grow, they reproduce. Okay, so these all are the characteristics of living organisms. So they are also the characteristics of microorganisms. It does not matter whether they are small, whether they are huge. Okay, but they are living organisms, so they show all the characteristics of living organisms. Now they are divided, microorganisms are divided into five major groups. These groups are bacteria, viruses, protozoa, fungi and algae. So these are the five different groups. This is bacteria. Okay, so there is bacteria lactobacillus, which converts milk into curd, and there is a bacteria rhizobium, which fix atmospheric nitrogen. So these bacteria, they causes certain diseases also. Then we come to viruses. Viruses are the smallest microorganisms. Okay, and they can develop inside the cells of the host organisms. These viruses, they do not show the characteristics of a living organisms outside the host. Only when they enter the host, which can be a animal, plant, or a animal, plant, or a another organism or a bacteria, only when they enter in the body of other living organism, and the body of other living organism where they enter is called as a host. So when viruses enter the host, then only they show some characteristic of the living organism, like reproduce. So when they enter the body of a host, then only viruses can increase in number. Okay, and viruses are not considered as cell also, as they lack the organelles of cell or cellular organelles. Okay, now viruses, they can cause diseases. So yes, here also viruses are outside the living cells, they behave as non-living things, but as soon as the viruses enter the living cells of other organisms, they start behaving as living things by carrying out the process of reproduction. So they use the machinery, or they use the energy of the host to show this characteristic. Okay, so because of this reason only, viruses are said to lie on the borderline dividing the living and the non-living things. Now viruses, they also cause certain diseases, but the diseases of viruses cannot be treated by antibiotics. Antibiotics are used to treat the diseases caused by bacteria and fungi. Antibiotics are the medicines. Then we come to protozoa. Protozoa are single cell microorganisms which are classified as animals. So these are some of the protozoa. Algae, they are plant like structures. Okay, they are plant like organisms. They have chlorophyll, they are autotrophic, they perform photosynthesis, but they are not considered as true plants, as they lack shoot root system. Is it clear? Then we come to fungi. This is another group of organisms, and they do not have chlorophyll, so they do not perform photosynthesis, so they also cause certain diseases. Okay, microorganisms, they are found everywhere, this I told you. Now student, microorganisms are useful also, harmful also to us. It is not that microorganisms are harmful, and it is not that microorganisms can be either harmful or useful. No, microorganisms can be harmful, can be useful, or some of the microorganisms, they do not affect us at all. Now in the air, in the environment, okay. Now I have noticed one thing, when we say or when I say air, all the students start looking up. Atmosphere is not up. What is atmosphere? The air surrounding us, everywhere the air is present. When if you will look down, if you will look on the floor, there also air is present. So when I say atmosphere, certainly I have seen the students, they start looking up. Atmosphere is everywhere, okay, down, up, everywhere on your sides air is present, and that air contains, what does that air contains? Gases, and that air contains microorganisms also. Microorganisms like bacteria, virus, fungi, all these microorganisms are present, but you are not aware of it because they are very very small and you cannot see them. So but microorganisms, but we are not affected by those microorganisms because microorganisms which is present, all microorganisms, they do not harm us, okay. There are harmless microorganisms also in the air, is it clear? But there are certain microorganisms which are harm us, and there are certain microorganisms which are useful to us, okay. So friendly microorganism, useful microorganisms. So I'll just tell you these points. I am not going to explain you in detail, otherwise we will not be able to finish this, okay. So microorganisms are used for making curd, bread and cake. They are used for the production of alcohol, wine, acetic acid. Generally here fungus is used, yeast, okay. And in preparation of curd, bacteria is used. Preparation of bread and cake, again yeast, which is a fungus, that is used. Microorganisms are used in the preparation of medicines like antibiotics, okay. So these antibiotics, they are derived, they are formed from a, or they are produced by fungus, okay. First antibiotic which was discovered or which was obtained from fungus was penicillin. Microorganisms are used in the agriculture to increase the fertility of the soil by fixing atmospheric nitrogen. And microorganisms, they clean up the environment by decomposing the organic matter, okay. So this all we have discussed in detail, and not one time, many times, and I am sure that you have understood it, okay. Now what is fermentation, students? The conversion, the process of conversion of sugar into alcohol by the action of yeast is called as fermentation. This also we have discussed in detail, okay. This is used for the preparation of alcohol, okay. Here cane juice, here fruit sugar is used, okay. And this fermentation was discovered by Louis Pasteur. And here this yeast is grown on the natural sugars, and then these natural sugars are converted into alcohol because yeast undergoes anaerobic respiration. Then this is the medicinal use, okay. This all I have told you. Vaccine, you all know what is a vaccine. Vaccine is a special kind of a preparation from which provides immunity against a particular disease, okay. There are certain diseases which are highly dangerous to humans, or not to humans but to other animals and plants also. So vaccine is given for those diseases, and generally these diseases are what? These are infectious diseases. Now you cannot say like this, the cancer is a highly dangerous disease, then diabetes is also highly dangerous disease, so we don't have vaccine for these diseases. Vaccines are generally for infectious diseases, okay. And this vaccine, it provides immunity. Immunity means it protects the body from a particular disease for a long time, okay. This all we have discussed. Now harmful microorganisms we will discuss. The microorganisms, they can cause disease also, and the microorganism which causes diseases are called as host, okay. So all the microorganisms cause diseases. Pathogens can be bacteria, virus, protozoa and fungus, okay. Now disease causing microorganisms in human, okay. So the those diseases, okay, which diseases? The diseases which can spread from an infected person to a healthy person through air, water, food or physical contact are called as communicable diseases, okay. So those microbial diseases, Okay, so how these diseases, what is the cause of this disease? These microorganisms, these pathogens, they are present in air, food, water, okay, and these are transferred to the healthy person from the infected person. Infected person means the person who has this microorganism. So this microorganism, it is transferred from the infected person to the healthy person through these agents. What are the agents? Air, water, food, insects, physical contact. Okay, so the communicable diseases can occur and spread in the following ways: by breathing of air containing microorganisms, by taking infected food or water, through insect bites like mosquitoes, by sharing infected injection needles, by physical contact with the infected person or using the articles of an infected person. Okay, so these are some of the ways of preventing the communicable diseases. Okay, now carriers of disease causing microorganisms. Generally there are two carriers of disease causing microorganisms. These are housefly and mosquitoes. These two insects, what they do, they carry the microorganisms. Okay, they carry the microorganism from the infected person and then they transfer that microorganism to the healthy person, and the healthy person also becomes sick. So these are these are the microorganisms, housefly and mosquito. Okay, so prevention of diseases spread by mosquitoes, these some of the points are given here which I have already discussed with you. So you just have to go through these points. Okay, food poisoning, you all know what is food poisoning. When you consume the food which is spoiled by microorganisms, especially bacteria and fungi, so if you consume that food, then you suffer from food poisoning. Or sometimes what happens, these microorganisms in the food, they produce certain poisonous substances, and okay, and which changes the color and the smell of the food. And if you take that food, then, or if you take that food, then we suffer from food poisoning. Is it clear? So preservation of food. Now sometimes when we cook food, and if the food is not consumed, then that food, what we do, we store that food. The food is stored in such a way that it is not spoiled. That is called as food preservation. So there are many methods of preserving the food, and the methods which are used for preserving the food is preservation of food by sun drying. Here the water content of the food is reduced because the presence of water promotes the growth of microorganisms. Preservation of food by heating, preservation of food by cooling, preservation of food by deep freezing, preservation of food by common salt, preservation of food by sugar, preservation of food by mustard oil and vinegar, preservation of food by using special chemicals which are called as preservatives, preservation of food by pasteurization, and preservation of food by packing in airtight packets. Nitrogen fixation, you all know that the living organisms are unable to consume free nitrogen which is present in the air. So this nitrogen is converted into the compounds of nitrogen by rhizobium bacteria, by blue-green algae, and sometimes by lightning. Okay, so these compounds of nitrogen, they come in the soil and then they can be used by the plants. Nitrogen cycle is what? The circulation of nitrogen element between the living and the non-living things. Okay, so when these nitrogen compounds, when they mix with the soil, then it is consumed, it is absorbed by the plants. In the plants, it is converted into proteins. The animals, they eat these plants, so these proteins, they are transferred to the animals. When plants and animals, they die, and in the excreta, or in the excreta of the animals also, these compounds, nitrogen compounds, are present. So what happens, these microorganisms, especially bacteria, they decompose these proteins into nitrogen compounds which goes back into the soil, thereby increasing the fertility of the soil. Or you can say, when these plants and animals, they die, the bacteria, they decompose it, they decompose the complex compounds into simple compounds, and they form manure. You know that manure is formed, and that manure contains what? That manure contains simple compounds of nitrogen. That manure gets mixed with the soil, the compounds get mixed with the soil, because in the manure the what is present, organic manure what is present, compounds of nitrogen are present, so they also get mixed with the soil, they get mixed with the water and is again utilized by the new plants. Some of the compounds of nitrogen that is converted into free nitrogen by denitrifying bacteria, so this nitrogen gas it goes back into the atmosphere, thereby maintaining the concentration of nitrogen. Okay students, so I have revised this chapter in short, but again I will recommend you to read the chapter thoroughly, understand the chapter thoroughly. And what I feel is this, ki I have given you only one chapter and this chapter is explained to you, and I have not explained much in one class, little I have explained to you, plus homework was also given to you. Okay, so I feel now you should be thorough with the chapter, you should not have problem in this chapter. But still, if you have any problem, if you have any doubt, you can clarify your doubts. And students, it's always better to understand the concept, understand the chapter, instead of learning the things by heart. So please read the chapter, understand the chapter, then practice questions on your own. Okay students, all the best for your exams. Have a nice day. Thank you very much.